Hello, everyone. Welcome to the Purpose Pursuers. And with me today is Justin Schultz from Canada. How are you, Justin?
I'm doing well. Thank you, Tammy, for having me.
Oh my gosh, I really appreciate you coming on because you, Justin, is a game designer. And he is in the middle of not only a game release, but he's also in the middle of kind of disrupting the industry a little bit, which is very exciting to me. And in the process of getting some feedback from his community and all that. So I so appreciate you for taking the time to do this, to talk to us today about your purpose and what that's been like for you, because I know you're in the thick of things right now. Mm-hmm. So if you would, why don't you explain to the good people how your game is different and how your the way that you're putting it out to your community and to the public is a little different than industry standard.
Cool, yeah. So I'm building an incremental game. That's the genre. It's a very minified, like small, simple game genre where the whole point of it is just to see your numbers go up. There's quite a few of these games on the market, especially in the mobile department, lots of them exploring, like, you know, they're all like addictive because seeing numbers go up is just inherently addictive.
Yes, it is. I agree. Yes.
So, I'm building incremental game, but I'm kind of like switching it up and doing it, a different way that nobody's done it before. This like really active sandbox kind of game, and yeah, I'm having a lot of fun with it and then exploring new stuff with it.
Yes.
Most incremental games, you know, like most mobile games, they don't charge you money up front, and instead they like have microtransactions. And like, that's a part of the whole loop, is you pay like the extra dollar and then you get a boost for a day, or, you know, like this is how they encourage you to pay.
Sure.
I'm not a fan of those strategies. I just prefer making fun games. And so right now I am just funneling my audience through my Patreon, and anybody who signs up gets like little rewards, like they get early access to patches that I'm building, and other little treats like desktop versions and things like that.
Nice.
So I'm trying to build an audience through Patreon right now. To what success I'll have, we'll still find out, but I've got a couple people already. So, yeah.
Fantastic. So this is the revolutionizing, the disrupting that I was referencing earlier that Justin is doing with his game and his community. He saw something in his industry that he did not care for. And so he said to himself, what am I going to do differently? So, and now he's doing it. And I love how you just said, you know, what results you'll get, you don't know. I mean, talk about courage to put yourself out there in a unique way and not, of course, have any kind of guarantee of what that's going to look like, but still to do it is amazing to me. And I have the utmost respect for you because you're willing to do that. So talk to us about what the blueprint process and discovering your purpose has done for you in helping you be willing to disrupt the industry with no guarantees.
Yeah. So a big thing that I had been pursuing just before I launched into the blueprint process was the pursuit of effortlessness. I believe that like effortlessness is a state you can achieve in life and live in it, doing things without like having that hard resistance that like, oh, I gotta get it done, but I don't want to, I gotta get it done. Like not having that in your life. And I reached out to you, Tammy, because I saw like one of your videos and I was like, well, this is really calling to me, and this is like calling to the effortlessness. Mm-hmm. And you like really brought it out of me. Like I realized I was doing a bunch of things I didn't want to do, and it just feels so much better to do it the way I want to do it rather than how it's supposed to be done. And that's like a part of the effortlessness.
Yeah.
This whole microtransaction stuff, you know, I could be doing it to like maybe make more sales, make more money, like right. Do it the way everybody else has been doing it, you know, do it
for sure.
The way it's being done.
Right.
But it feels so much easier and so much more fun just to do it my own way and see if I can figure it out myself, you know, like have faith that I can figure out whatever process I take, I can explore fully.
Yeah.
And that I will be held in any path I take as well, that I like no matter what, success will happen. Maybe not like financially, like right away or like anything like that, but just the overall success will happen. Whatever in life I'm meant to have, I will have. And so like I feel like the blueprint process just like planted me straight into this space. And ever since then, like that's what kickstarted this game for me. And I have loved the last 4 months that I've been doing the blueprint process and working on this game. So, yeah.
I so appreciate what you're saying. And I honestly had forgotten that that was your original intent, was that state of effortlessness. But I can see how the blueprint process basically, please correct me if I'm wrong, but it gave you validation to pursue effortlessness. Did it not?
Yeah. I think the biggest thing for me at the front was that it made me question what I was doing at the time, because I was pursuing business ventures that I wasn't enjoying as much, that I was doing more from like my family for other reasons other than like actually enjoying it.
Yeah.
And when you questioned, like the first interview I had with you, you questioned it right away. Is like, is that something you want to be doing? And it was a question I hadn't actually asked myself. And I like sat there, I was like, oh no, I don't want to ask this question.
I know. Because it definitely sent you, it closed down one road and sent you on another road that you didn't know what it was going to be like.
I had no idea.
Yeah. And family obligation and all that jazz.
Right. So it took me 2 weeks to find this game after that. So
isn't that interesting?
I had to do nothing for 2 weeks. Basically
right that. And it is interesting how we almost have to shut down one thing in order to be open to that next thing. And so I appreciate the guts that you expressed in doing that.
Oh yeah, I've noticed that a lot, like even on like an energy level. I noticed I've always wanted to make video games, but I could never do it with like my 9-to-5 job. Like it was just too much. Right. and it took me a long time to realize that I needed to actually just cut out what I didn't want to do in my life to pursue what I did want to do.
Huge leap for you.
Yeah.
I mean, my goodness, that's what all this last 5 minutes or however long we've been talking, it is amazing how many times just in the 4 short months that we've been doing this, you've made these massive leaps of confidence, not knowing where you were going to land, but recognizing, if I may, that where you were standing is not where you want it to be.
Yeah. Yes, for sure. And I still don't know where I'm going to fall. Like I'm still in the free fall right now.
Right.
Like I'm not making enough money off this game to support myself at the moment.
Mm-hmm.
So I have no idea what the future has in store for me, but I am loving it anyways.
And I appreciate what you had said a couple minutes ago about how you're confident that you will be provided for because you're following your blueprint. You have so bought into the blueprint philosophy that is, hey, this is who you were custom designed to be. And if you be that person, you will be fulfilled. You'll have everything that you need, the ideas, the creativity, the energy, and the supply. And I so appreciate how much you owned that process, that philosophy, and consequently leapt. You've leapt multiple times. And like you said, the financial remuneration hasn't shown up yet, but everything else has in terms of the ideas, the flow that you talk so much about. And I just love how much you've been able to let go of obligation.
Yeah. And it's still a learning process for me. The key word I like to use is surrender, because there's so many times where I'm like, I want to do my game a certain way. I want to do this project a certain way. And I invite control into the mix and like trying to get things right. But it's just like the surrender that everything is perfect. Everything is what it needs to be. I don't need to like force myself to do anything. It's just going to happen. And and that state is beautiful to live in. Mm-hmm. So yeah.
And I think what you were saying earlier too is so important, that even though that was your objective, this state of effortlessness and to surrender, we often cannot see ourselves accurately. which is why, you know, physically we use a mirror to make sure we don't have something in our teeth or our hair is not all wonky before we walk out the door. But having someone else in your life, and I know you've got some significant personal relationships in your life that act like a mirror back to you. And I know that that's what the blueprint process has done for you as well. Mm-hmm. It's given you that capacity to be able to see yourself clearly and recognize, oh, I want to live in a state of effortlessness, but with this particular thing, I'm still laboring under the obligations of others or the standard that somebody else has set and for some strange reason is now the expectation.
Yeah. Yeah. I have appreciated so much getting like this mirror feedback from you in our talks, seeing my strengths and like understanding how I'm different from other people makes things so much clearer in a lot of senses. Like I don't have to like look at what I lack because I have strengths in like other areas. Obviously, like you can always improve your weaknesses or whatever, but it's just like the perspective that you can get from somebody like reflecting to you what your talent is, what your strengths are, like what you enjoy doing. Just seeing it on paper is so different. I love it. Yeah, I love it.
Oh, I'm so glad to hear that. And I know exactly what you're saying. Having discovered my own blueprint and all that at the same time, I also feel like when I'm standing in front of my blueprint, like you said, the decisions become so much more clear. And because there's a focus, there's a natural focus to your blueprint. And the other thing that I find is that it backs up what your instincts are telling you, doesn't it?
Yes.
So yeah. You have noticed a pull in certain directions and a resistance to certain directions. And you've done a good job, I think, prior to knowing me and going through the blueprint process of following that to the best of your ability. But the blueprint process, I feel like with that inventory of tools that it gives you, it backs up that instinct. And now you can see, oh, that's why I don't want to do it that way. And that's why I want to do it that way. So almost like proves for you that you can do that. Go.
Mm-hmm. Even super recently, it's crazy because it's just like it happens. You just naturally get into ruts where you're doing things with effort because you think it's what you need to do.
Absolutely.
Like our chat this week was like so big for me because I had planned, I was doing a huge major release today, or I had one planned for today, and I was debating pushing it back because I wanted a bunch of like specific content in my game. Before I launched, because I thought that it would be like the launch would be better with this content in it.
Right.
It wasn't until like we talked, I noticed how heavy it felt to actually wait. Like I thought about pushing it back a week and then I thought about like my next week of work I had planned. And I was like, oh, get me out of this. I just want to like release this thing right now.
Right.
But I had shut off that path because just like my planning and like my past self had come up with the structure and I was just following it because whatever, you know, but you brought that like questioning in, you brought the like, oh yeah, what do you actually want to do right now? What's effortlessness for you right now? And right. That was actually just letting go of this version and releasing it as is and coming, releasing the content later as just like little updates. And I've been having a ton of fun watching people play my game this past day and a habit. So yeah.
I appreciate you bringing up that characteristic of what it feels like when you're in your blueprint and when you're not in your blueprint. Mm. And I think you're absolutely right. You can make decisions better when you just assess, how am I feeling about this? Is it a sense of heavy, like a ball and chain around my neck weighing me down, or is it lifting? Is it bringing me up? And just by taking that quick assessment, you actually know which path to take, which path is in your blueprint and which path isn't.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. It's such a learning process to like, just be able to pick that up more and more like readily. It helps so much having you around every week, just to like check in. But yeah, it is such a learning process, still learning and still loving it. Like, you know, like it's so fun to like have these moments where it's like, oh, you know what? Maybe I was thinking about this all wrong and this is something else I want to do. Those moments for me are so wonderful. I enjoy them a lot.
I know exactly what you're talking about. It's like, it's self-validation. Like, it's okay. First of all, yes, I am one of a kind. That's powerful. Mm. And it's okay for me to make decisions and run my life according to my one of a kindness. How freeing is that? And then, like you said, I think it's an ongoing process. I find myself still getting trapped by the expectations of others all the time. And mm-hmm. I've known my blueprint for 13, 14 years, and I still do this. So I completely get you. And it makes sense because we were raised in a carrot and stick way. You know, we want to strive for the carrot and we want to avoid the stick. So we were raised with that ball and chain around our neck, and it feels really weird letting go of it. And that's why, right? That's why I want to give you so many kudos, because I have just noticed, like, from the get-go, really, how much you've assimilated and just owned this philosophy that comes with having your own blueprint. And I am just so, like I said, I have so much respect for you because of how often you're willing to make that choice for your blueprint instead of against it, even when it means not sure where the money's coming from. I might irritate my sister and my mom, you know, right? Like all the different things. And yet you've consistently been loyal to your blueprint.
Yeah. It's like nothing to me though. It's just the way it feels is the best. Like, it is, like, once you realize that letting go of the heaviness and just following the lightness, I feel like it's completely shifted my perspective. Like, sometimes heavy moments come up that are hard to release, but they're like easier and easier to let go the more I do it. And I just want to pass it on too. Like, I see my friends and family, and I just question it. You know, I just throw in those like little nuggets of like, you don't seem to be enjoying this so much. Is there something else you could be doing that you would enjoy more? Nice. And it's just like, it's something I do with myself. And now it's like spreading out. And I just love spreading it around because life has been magical, like just straight up magical for the past couple months for me. And it's so cool.
I appreciate what you're saying about it not being as hard as it may seem to let go of obligation. Mm-hmm. And you're right, because when you do tap into that, okay, blueprint way, non-blueprint way, it's so inherently motivating. And it brings you that gratification, that satisfaction, the fulfillment as you're doing it, and it just pulls you. So it's really mm-hmm. hard to resist it, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah. It's super hard to the point where it's just like, okay, yeah, something's heavy here. Let's figure it out. You know, like that's just the thing now.
Yeah.
Let's get down to it.
Right. Goody, goody. I get to do things my way.
Yes. Yeah. I get to learn and like evolve in little ways now. And when it's me doing things I want to do too, mm-hmm. the confidence I have been feeling is like astronomical. Like, I feel like I've transformed a lot just in like how I embody myself, because now when I make decisions and I know like they feel good to me, like mm-hmm. I can just execute without as much worry as I had before.
Right.
And that is like a beautiful feeling. Even like conversations like the one we're having right now, I feel like is something that I'm just way more confident in, because I have faith that everything I say is like has some sort of meaning, just like I'm here to do what I'm meant to do. Like I can just sit in that and like just experience life from that place and just boldly take step forwards one at a time.
Yeah. I appreciate what you're saying. It is kind of like a natural confidence. You're not having to bolster it. You're not having to put it together. It's just inevitable, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. It's not like I went in, hey, I want to be more confident. And this is what I'm going to be doing. It's just like, oh, hey, I actually know what I like doing. I actually know what I want to do. And like now I'm seeing my strengths too. Like, I see my social skills like evolving, and you know, like maybe there's way more value in my word than I mm-hmm. thought I had before.
Right.
You know, like, yeah.
Yeah. So if I'm hearing you correctly, it's oozing out into all of your life, not just in games. Yeah. That's fantastic. Oh,
totally. Yeah.
That's what we want to hear. So relationships, projects, business, everything. And it makes sense. If you've been born with that blueprint, we should be using it as often as we're awake.
Oh yeah. It's getting everywhere in my life.
That's so good. And I love
confetti that's exploding.
Oh, that's a great analogy. I love it. I also love how you've been throwing that confetti on other people around you too, helping them understand the concept of, hey, I am one of a kind and I can do things within my own flow.
Yeah. And again, it's just natural. It's not like I'm purposely walking over to people and throwing confetti on them, but I see the way they talk and it feels like a past me talking or something like that. Like talking about expectations, shoulds and all that. And I'm like, hey, you're saying should there, like, have you ever questioned this? You know,
yes.
Like, and so it's just like natural. And it's just, I'm just walking around and passing it around. Shedding apples is the term I love.
Shedding apples. That's a good one. I like that. Yes. Especially because I love apples.
I don't know if I do, but.
Oh, but you like to shed them regardless.
It's very, I like to shed them.
Yeah. Very giving of you. Well, thank you so much for hanging out with us today and sharing your wealth. Oh my goodness. I so appreciated everything that you said. It was so many great points about what the blueprint process is doing for you. And I obviously very, very much appreciate the honor of being able to help you uncover it and use it. It's my favorite thing to do in the whole wide world. So thank you.
Yeah. Thanks, Tammy, for having me.
Absolutely. And thanks everyone for hanging out with us today. And we'll see you next time right here in the Blueprint Zoom room.